Okay. Well, we'll do it. We'll do it next week then. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Well, I get I got Tiffany Haywood in here, so we get the Mrs. T. So. Okay.
Oh, Pat from the cave.
Okay. All right. Look it up. All right, partner. Talk to you then. All right. Bye.
Let me do a quick intro. Hey, guys. So, sorry about the whole, fumbling. I was just trying to set up so that you could see both myself and Wade. We're getting ready to go live on WIDU 1600 AM and talk about all what's happening in Fayetteville this weekend and the coming weekends, as well as what it's like to be a blogger here in Fayetteville, North Carolina. So stay tuned, watch, and I would love it if you guys would actually tune in. Again, that's WIDU 1600 AM. Stay tuned. Kind of see both of us. Because I had a couple bloggers like, can you please live stream it so I can go back and watch it? Because some of them aren't here, or yeah. Some of them are like at the color run.
Yeah. So it used to be they had a. Are they gonna, do you know if they're going to put a webcam in here like they had in the old studio?
I think they are, yes, sir.
And then. You can actually watch it on WIDURadio.com.
Oh, cool. Yeah, because one of them said, she said, I thought they had a live stream, but I can't find it. I can't get it to work. And I said, well,
yeah, I'll try to set my camera. Studios.
So this is a new building? Completely new?
Yes. Okay. Yeah, they just started this week broadcasting out of here.
Cool. Sorry, look at me trying
to... We have about 8.5 minutes before you all are on the air.
Okay.
Okay.
So we'll have how often do we have breaks in here?
Give me 1 second and I'll let you
know. Okay. But you'll just give us a heads up on it anyway, right? It's not a problem. Okay.
9 o'clock hour. How many do you think you're probably gonna need?
I'm gonna end up with 4 sponsors, is what my goal is.
Okay.
So if I have that, then I'll have, you know, 4 minutes worth of breaks.
Okay.
And some of them may be in 2 30-second spots for them. And then, of course, we'll have the bumper lead in and the what are they called? The billboard lead in and the billboard.
So you've done radio before, obviously. You sound like you know what you're doing.
Never done it before.
Now we
really?
No, I've done it.
If you need more than two, just let me know.
Yeah, you will. You just let me know when they're coming up, what we got, how long they're going to be. Are they going to be 1 minute or?
They'll probably be like a minute and a half.
Minute and a half, okay.
I'm excited. When Jenny said it, I was like, that sounds like so much fun.
Okay, that needs to go to 4.
I'm going to see if I can get Patrick to be one of the sponsors.
LeClaire?
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be cool. He's a cool guy.
Yeah. I mean, it's inexpensive. It's $250 a month.
Oh, okay.
You get 4 shows during the month where you get the lead in and you get what they call the billboard on the end, you know, brought to you by.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is brought to you by at the end. Then you get your 2 30-seconds or 1 1-minute in the show.
Okay.
And then you get another, I think, 2 per week elsewhere on the radio program in here. You know.
Oh, well, see, so, that just went live. And I'll help, promote that. Let's see if there's any, or let me know if anybody you know that you think
I forgot we were live, Patrick. Yeah, I'm telling him. Come.
Patrick, he's going to come. Just know what's happening.
So, yeah, we're going to be looking for sponsors and be a good... A good thing.
Yeah, that will. And I think that's a great way, especially for some of the downtown spots to get there.
Yeah, well.
Even bloggers, though, because bloggers might want to have a little bit extra.
Well, that's, I hadn't thought about that. That could be good, too.
I would consider it.
Okay. So, but I think it's going to be fun. I think Fable needs this right now. I think it needs, I know Fayetteville has been a place where we've had a loss of a lot of young people because mm-hmm. they don't think there's anything to do here. There's nothing that reaches out to them, and there's a lot going on right now that's changing Fayetteville. I mean, I'm still young at heart, even though I'm old. You know,
age is only a number. It's really only a number.
So, you know, and I've seen what's happened at our restaurant and what we're trying to do, and I think there's a, I think there's a lot of things going on that will change how Fable looks to, you know, a younger set of people.
So. Yeah, and there's really a lot to do in Fable, but I think people just have this mindset that there isn't. Because last night I went to see Crowns, right over at KK Regional Theater. It was like a Broadway production. You know what I'm saying? Like, it was quality production.
Yeah.
And I got to do it right here in Fayetteville. I didn't have to go to Raleigh. I didn't have to go to Durham. I didn't have to go to Charlotte. Right here in Fayetteville. And honestly, I didn't even realize that it was right there. And so I happened to come across it in a press release that I was helping to boost. And I said, hey, wait, I didn't know this play was here.
Yeah. Well, so. there's some good... good acts coming in at the Coliseum now, too.
Yes, the Crown. Really good. They always have good stuff over there, too. I think WWE is coming in a couple of weeks. Because there's a bunch of stuff happening for Memorial Day weekend, too. Like, I just wrote up 14 things to do Memorial Day weekend, and that's just cutting the surface. There's so much to do. But I don't think people realize it.
Yeah.
But that's what we're here for.
Well, and then every October at the Crown is the WIDU anniversary.
Really? Now, see, I didn't know about that.
Oh, gosh, yeah, they packed the place. It's big. They want a popular, it's kind of interesting the way they do it. They have the old school gospel singing, and then they have newer artists, and they always have a big, big, big headliner artist that comes in.
See, I'm going to have to, one, promote that, and two, see about getting myself some tickets, because that sounds really fun.
Yeah, and it goes over, I think, 5 days.
So it's not a one-day event.
No, and then they tie in things like they have a small business promotion. They have some forums and stuff, and sometimes they'll have a motivational speaker and have different stuff that all gets tied in together with it. It's really cool.
That sounds cool.
And I went, was it last year or year before? You want to see the Crown packed?
That's the event to go to?
I mean, we're talking... 8,000-10,000 people back in there.
Wow. I can see the draw for that, though, seriously. So
I mean, people come from all over to come to it. It's crazy big.
We are 1600 AM WIDU Fayetteville. WIDURadio.com.
Yeah, I was so
we're getting ready to come in.
I hear our song.
Can't help but think that, right? This man was a genius. Boss man, you let me know when you're ready. And I'm going to step out and get you guys something to drink, and then I'll come back.
As soon as he gets through what's going on.
Okay. And then if you get a phone call, I'll say call them. If they give me their name, I'll let you know their name.
Okay.
You'll be able to hear them through here.
Okay.
But it's going to sound like they're in a hole because that's not the speaker we normally use.
Yeah.
And the numbers and the stations are there. I call that your little cheat sheet.
Good morning, Fayetteville. It's time for good old Wade Fowler to be back on the air on WIDU Radio. I can't tell you how excited I am to be here. We are WIDU 1600 AM in Fayetteville, North Carolina, WIDU 1160 AM in Red Springs, North Carolina, WAGR 1340 AM in Lumberton, North Carolina, WEWO 1460 AM in Laurinburg, NC, and we're on the World Wide Web at WeDoRadio.com. Call in number, if you want to call in and talk to us today, is 910-483-6111. That's 910-483-6111. And just to give you an idea of what this show is going to be about, it's brand new. We got a new concept here, and I thought What's Going On would be a good theme song for it, because we want to be about what's going on in Fayetteville, particularly from either food, entertainment, fashion, whatever's happening in Fayetteville. Business, any of that kind of stuff that would be of interest to people around Fayetteville to say, hey, you know what? Fayetteville's a cool place to live. You know, I don't know if you heard in the lyrics of that song, it said, things aren't what they used to be. And let me tell you what, Fable is not what it used to be. We used to be thought about as a one-trick pony with just being basically a military town. And that's not who we are. It's a big part of who we are, but it's not all of who we are. And so I thought what I'd do is bring together some people that have their finger on the pulse of what's going on around Fable, and bring in some bloggers and that type of thing. And part of the reason I'm into it, too, is that I've taken up to creating a small business in Fable. It's called Fowler Southern Gourmet. It's a restaurant at 723 West Row Ann Street. We serve up some really, really good food. We'll talk about that sometime. But I also wanted to just talk about different events that are going on in Fable. And today I've got a special guest with me. She's one of our local bloggers, Tiffany Haywood. Her blog is The Mrs. T. Mm-hmm. And she is super excited about telling you some of the stuff that's going on in Fable. Tiffany, thanks for being here and welcome to the show.
Thanks, Wade. I appreciate it so much. Thank you so much for bringing me in today, and I am super excited to share a little bit about what's happening in Fayetteville, because Fayetteville is the place to be. Whether everybody realizes it or not, that's what I'm here for, to help spread the word about the amazing events that are happening here in Fayetteville. Do you want me to go ahead and give
well, you know, we've got a few, going on right now, so yeah. Let's go ahead and talk about them. How about the Color Run? You've done that.
The Color Run, oh my goodness. This is one of those events that are good for the entire family, from you, your spouse, to your kids. I've participated in the Color Run for 3 years. Today, I'm not there, but it's still amazing fun. It's basically a 5K. You can walk, you can run, you can stroll. They have strollers, you can bring your kids. It doesn't matter. You set your own pace. But every single person is a winner because you get this amazing Color Run medal right at the end of it. Not to mention all the powder that you get sprayed on you. So the Color Run is pretty much happiness all day long. They spray a cornstarch-based color on you, and you can get it puffed on your shirt. If you don't want it in your hair, you can avoid it. It's totally up to you. And we have quite a few Fayetteville NC bloggers that are actually there today taking part in all the fun.
Yeah, so I understand they tell you to wear, basically wear a white shirt or
white
shorts or whatever, wear white.
Because the colors show up a lot better on the white.
And every, what is it, about every K? Somewhere
every mile marker, they put a different color on you. There's a different color. It goes from blue, yellow, green, purple, pink. Pink is, of course, my very favorite station. So they call them color stations, and you get to stop through each one.
Yeah, and then you, when it's over, they have a big party.
Yes, an awesome party. And there's a DJ throughout, and the main stage is where the party takes place at the end, and they give out prizes. They throw out T-shirts all throughout the race, or especially at the end of it. There are normally a couple of food truck vendors there as well, mm-hmm. and stages are little vendor stations set up for, sometimes they've had, I want to say, a couple of military vendors there too, mm-hmm. and there's water stations all throughout, so it's a great way to have a day of fun.
That's super. All right, so that's, unfortunately, that one's already going on, so we're a little late to get there, but we want you to look for that for next year. But that's something that's going on in Fable. And the other thing we've got coming up that's starting, I think, at 10 o'clock today is the Field of Honor opening ceremony over at the Airborne and Special Operations Museum in that big field between there and the North Carolina Veterans Museum. So you've also participated with that, haven't you?
Yes, I was actually there on Tuesday morning to help assemble some of the flags, and it was just an honor, honestly. We helped to put the flags onto the poles, and then the Boy Scouts and Cub Scouts actually came out later on this week, and they placed them in the field itself. So today is the opening ceremony where you get to see all the flags on display in memorial for all of our fallen veterans and everyone who served our country.
That's great. And then also, I think I wanted to mention something that's going on. This is not something that's a fun thing going on, but it's something that's really important to Fayetteville. There is a building business rally mm-hmm. that's going to take place on Tuesday at the Fayetteville Technical Community College. It's an event that's been put together by my good friend Darswell Rogers, one of the commissioners on the Fayetteville Public Works Commission. And it is for any small business in the Fayetteville area, or even large business, it doesn't matter, mm-hmm. any business in the Fayetteville-Cumberland County region, this area, to come and to find out how to do business with all of the government entities here. So it's going to be, you're going to have the City of Fayetteville, you're going to have Fayetteville Public Works Commission. Our budget, the Fayetteville Public Works Commission alone is $365 million a year budget. Wow. So that's a lot, you know. Yeah. And then you've got Cape Fear Valley Regional Medical Center is going to be there. The school system is going to be there. The county is going to be there. I'm sure I'm forgetting some other ones that are going to be there. The North Carolina DOT is going to be there. There's over $10 billion worth of business over the next 5 to 10 years that's going to be done in this area. And they're trying to help small companies here and companies in the area get started and find out how to do it. So that's something that's also looking that you can look forward to coming up to help see Fayetteville grow. And by the way, there will also be classes in there. There will be people in there that will be able to help you learn how to go through the bid process if you've never done it before to help people get business. And I think that's a really neat thing. So it's from 3 to 7 this coming Tuesday at Fayetteville Technical Community College. There's a lot going on in Fayetteville, folks. And by the way, if you know something that's going on that we don't bring up, or you want to ask about anything going on, our call-in number is 910-483-6111. Don't be afraid to call in. We would love to talk to you. That actually makes the show a little bit more interactive and makes it a lot more fun for us. So, Tiffany, why don't you talk to us real quickly about blogging? There may be some people listening today that say, well, what in the world? You know, I mean, if they're old like me, they may not understand blogging. Just, you know, kind of what you do,
okay.
A little bit about blogging in general and then about you in specific, how you approach it and what you cover on your blog. And of course, tout your blog so you get more followers.
Well, thank you, Wade. Okay. So blogging is basically, when I first started blogging, let's put it like this, what I thought it was an online journal, but it's a lot more than that. Blogging is basically a way for the average person to share their thoughts, their interests, their passions in an online forum. You get to design it. You get to set up what your topics are going to be. You get to choose how you want to approach your audience. But it's your platform, and you're open to an amazing audience. Like, the audience possibilities are endless. Now, blogging, when it comes to social media and media influence, it has evolved so much. A lot of brands and companies are starting to see the awesome resource that a blogger can actually be. The biggest benefit I think that a brand can get from using a blogger and their influence is that organic nature that they have. We get to give the audience our viewpoint the same way they would see it. There's nothing like hearing the opinion of someone on something straight from how they feel,
mm-hmm.
versus an actor who's paid to say, this is what the brand wants you to know, and this is what the brand wants you to feel. But from a blogger's perspective, we tell you exactly the experience that we're having as we're having it, and most times we're just like you. My audience tends to be stay-at-home moms, working moms too as well. It's evolved over the past 5 years. Actually, in August, I'm going to celebrate 5 years on my blog.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm kind of sort of excited. So when I first started, I was pretty much focused towards stay-at-home moms because that's what I was. Mm-hmm. My husband was deployed. I was spending the entire day with kids all under 5, 3 kids under 5, and 1 teenager.
And you still have your hair.
Yes, and my sanity, somewhat, just a little bit. But that was my day, and I needed an outlet. I wanted to talk to someone. I wanted interaction. I wanted adult feedback. So my blog started out as an online journal. It was a place for me to write and have other people say what they felt about my writing. It wasn't until about a year or two into it that I realized it was becoming more than that to me. I was writing about local events. I was writing about things that I was doing in my community, and people were responding. They wanted to know what was happening in Fayetteville, and it just prompted me to want to share it even more. Mm-hmm. But that's when I started to see brands approach and different companies approach, because they wanted that organic viewpoint. They wanted someone who was living that day to day and experiencing it and could give their honest opinion about it.
And probably because you also developed a level of trust with the people that read your blog and,
yes,
and follow up what you're doing.
And trust is a lot. It has a lot to do with it. As a blogger, you always want to give your honest opinion. Even if you're getting paid for that content, you still want to give what you truly feel about it, because you don't want it to become any other paid sponsorship.
Yeah, which means probably you won't take anything that you don't believe in. So,
exactly.
Which is a really good thing, too.
I think that's the part I love the most. I get to be choosy. So I've had brands approach me, and if it was a product or an event or something I just honestly didn't believe in, I have the right to say no.
Well, I think we're getting ready to come up on a break here real soon, so I just wanted to double check. This is we're getting back in the flow of things. I've got 3 minutes to go. All right, so
three minutes to spare.
So talk to me about you cover a lot of different topics, but I think you mentioned to me also fashion.
Every once in a while. I'm not what you would call a fashionista. I think I'm a mom fashion person, meaning my mom fashion is what's comfortable, what's functional, and what I can do with a bunch of kids in tow. So if it's something that I have to worry about a heel breaking or I gotta try to keep a strap fixed, 9 out of 10, I can't wear that. But I think my standard mom uniform is a pair of Chucks, a good t-shirt, and some jeans. But when it comes to expanding that fashion on my blog, I love to share about places like Pressed on Hay Street, who has like an amazing selection of t-shirts. You can always up your standard of what your fashion is, even if it's a casual outfit.
Yeah. I love the folks over at Pressed. By the way, Pressed has the absolute best popsicles.
Yes, the Loco Pops.
The Loco Pops, those things. They're so good.
They're addictive, though. Yeah, it's dangerous. Yeah.
And I just want you to know that, we actually went down, you're speaking of t-shirts, I just went down the other day to Yellow Crayon.
Yes.
Downtown Fayetteville, and gave them our logo and had t-shirts printed. I mean, they take a printer and they just print it right on your t-shirt for you while you wait. I mean, it's...
Oh, so it's not even an order.
You don't even have to wait. Yeah, you can go in there. You can go in there with a computer graphic, or if you can take a picture, give them the picture, and they'll load it in the computer and boom. You print it on your shirt for you while you wait.
Crayon, you might see me pretty
soon. So, that's the kind of stuff that's going on in Fayetteville that's kind of cool that we need to know about. And I'll take a minute. It's, okay. Oh, well, our break time has come up. We're going to go to a break. We'll be back in about a minute, minute and a half. Thanks for listening to what's going on here on We Do Radio.
Thank you.
How was that?
Good.
I was trying not to get tongue-tied. We can also talk about Dirtbag
Ales.
They're having their...
We'll talk about that later. Okay. We can talk about the farmer's market.
Oh, yeah, not Dirtbag, but the farmer's market. I was trying to think of other stuff that's happening this weekend.
Yeah.
Hey folks, if a shiny new Buick or GMC is on your wish list, don't sign anything until you come to Bleeker in Red Springs. Regal, Enclave, La Crosse, Toronto, and of course, GMCCR, Terrain, and Acadia.
The absolute
best selection with the lowest and best prices
waiting for you at Bleeker and Red Springs. And as Carolina's
original king of trucks and SUVs, you get to choose from a huge selection of GMCCR 1500s and 2500s when you shop Bleeker. Worried about getting financed?
Anything that you've seen that really jumps out at you when you come back, there'll be something that you just recently found in Fable that you really like, or something that really jumped out that you love, something you've written about in your blog lately that would be
Bleeker Buick GMC delivering world class service with small town sales.
Because the most recent stuff I did was to promote Memorial Day. Other than the Flashback Friday that's coming up. We don't cover that yet.
Flashback Friday.
That's what we're doing for Fourth Friday.
Fourth Friday, yeah, we cover that coming up.
Yeah, it's actually Breakfast Club themed.
Okay.
So it's going to be 80s costume contest to help promote the businesses downtown. So that's coming up. That's what I've been working on lately. I'm actually helping plan that night.
To get rid of the roaches in your home. Just a little dabble, do ya?
Good old Jeff Thompson.
All you have to do is put this simple gel out along your kitchen and your bathrooms, and you're going to get rid of roaches in 3 days. It is not an issue. Where are you going to find it? Well, downtown at Bell's Seed Store,
15
right across the street from the courthouse, 230 East Russell Street, where we can take care of all your bugs and all your bug problems. So come on down and see us at Bell's.
All righty. Let me know when you're ready.
Anytime.
All righty. You can begin in 3, 2, showtime.
And we're back on We Do Radio here, the We Do Radio Network. If you'd like to, you can listen on WIDUradio.com. And again, we're 1600 AM in Fayetteville, 1160 AM in Red Springs, 1340 AM in Lumberton, 1460 AM in Laurinburg. And I know that was a quick flyby for you, but I know y'all know where to find WIDU. And I want to tell you a little bit about where to find Fowler's Southern Gourmet Restaurant. serving some of the best barbecue you've had. We do barbecue fusion. This is the idea behind the show, to find small places like this, local places that do things a little bit differently than you find elsewhere in town. Everything's made fresh at our restaurant. We even make our own ketchup to make our barbecue sauce from. We grind our own cabbage for our slaw, make our own dressings, make our own, and we blend concepts. Go to a barbecue restaurant. Where would you think you go to a barbecue restaurant and find a sandwich called the Angry Hawaiian? Which could be made with either pork or chicken, and then has a homemade kicked up teriyaki sauce, pineapple that's been put on the grill, been grilled, and then with a little bit of cayenne pepper, and then a couple of strips of bacon and some jalapenos on top of it. So, I mean, on a brioche bun. We blend different things together to make it happen and just have a lot of fun. Yeah, it does work. Hey, wake up your taste buds. There we go. I heard that. That's good. So, but the concept of crafting stuff is really good. That's why I like Crest. They're so different from other people. That's why I like what we do. That's why also why I like the food truck scene. You know, one of the big things I think is really cool is the food truck scene. If you haven't tried Bob Ann's fried chicken, you should really try her fried chicken. I'm telling you what, it's so good.
So good. And or then 507 empanadas.
507 empanadas and our burger got the best burgers around. I mean, you know, there's this scene that if you haven't looked, if you're on Facebook, if you have a Facebook account, you should look some of these places up. You know, call up food trucks from Fayetteville. You know, there's just a great scene. California Tacos, those guys are really great. There's a new one out now called Blasian Asian. I want to give those guys a try.
I saw that one. It looks very interesting. They're doing that fusion to the utmost.
Yeah. So the food scene is growing in Fayetteville, and it doesn't always have to be. And listen, this is a guy who eats at a chain restaurant pretty much every morning. I hope my wife's not listening.
Don't.
But you know, the local scene is really cool. That's what we're trying to promote in this show. What's going on locally, small locally owned businesses. Broadcasting this from a locally owned radio station. Mm-hmm. And by the way, if you're listening out there and you're an advertiser and you want to keep, you know, and you're a small business, and I've heard some small business advertising around Fayetteville saying, you know, if you come with us instead of this money stays here, 70% of the money stays here and then grows in the local area. Well, the same goes if you advertise on a locally owned radio station. That money doesn't go out to some national group somewhere else, sucked out of the county. It stays right here and works in your community. So you guys ought to be thinking about WID Radio. That's what I'm telling you. Now, we got something else coming up in Fayetteville. There's this little thing that I'm sure nobody out there has heard about called Fourth Friday.
Yes.
Why don't you talk about what's coming up?
Fourth Friday is just what it sounds like. Every month, every Fourth Friday, the downtown area, the Cool Springs Downtown District, helps to organize an event right in downtown Fayetteville. It's Hay Street, Persons, Maxwell, all of that area gets together, and we pick a theme, and we just have fun for the entire Friday. This Fourth Friday, we're actually going to have a theme of Flashback Fourth Friday, and guess what year we're flashing back to, Reed? I'm sure you can remember this.
The 1980s.
No, the 80s. Yes, it's going to be so super retro. Fun. Retro is what it is. And you get to wear all your 80s gear. We're having a costume contest. You can bring out all your neon colors, all your little jelly bracelets, everything you want to wear. And the theme is going to be based on the movie, The Breakfast Club. And okay. Do you remember The Breakfast Club?
No, I don't.
Okay. The Breakfast Club had a clique of kids that got detention. It's basically half the movie is in the detention hall. But we're focusing on that clique of kids, which was a jock or athlete. They had the princess or like the little pretty girl. There was the outcast. And then there was also the brain. And so what our
So the brain was the nerd?
The brain was the nerd.
Okay.
I think I could fit into one of those. The outcast was basically like a goth type girl.
Okay.
Who nobody wanted to deal with. And then there was the jock who was the athlete. Mm-hmm. And that's what our theme's going to be. So if you come downtown on Fourth Friday and you check in at 222 Hay Street, we're going to have a yearbook there for you. You grab that yearbook and you start making your way to the designated stores, and they're going to judge your costume, whether you want to come dressed as the jock or the geek or the nerd or however you want to come dressed. bring out your 80s best to this week's Sports Friday. It's May 25th from 6 to 9 p.m.
Well, you know what I was wearing in the 1980s?
Do I want to know? Wait.
It was a green one-piece Nomex flight suit.
Ah, see.
I was an Air Force pilot.
You get respect for that. I thought you were going somewhere else completely.
No, I had this big old white helmet with a double glare shield in front.
Yeah,
of me.
Yeah.
You had to put both visors down.
I'm not sure. Now, my 80s, believe it or not, I think I was 2 when the 80s started. And
oh, so are you going to wear diapers?
Yeah, I was in a onesie and a blanket.
Well, see, I was in a onesie.
Oh my gosh, so we have that in common. We both had onesies in the 80s. Well, my onesie was probably slightly different, but this is going to be my way to explore the 80s since I was only 2 when it actually started.
How many people come down for Fourth Friday?
We have anywhere from 2,000 to, I think they said one time it was 3,000.
Whoa.
So it gets packed down there, but it's all in a great way. There's live music. There's vendors that are going to be down there. We're starting the vendors, and there's food trucks that are going to be there. So it's going to be a night to remember. Yeah.
And the Arts Council usually has some kind of a musical event going on at that time too, don't they?
Yes, yes. There's going to be a stage band, and then there's also, I believe we're trying to work on a DJ that's going to be having those latest, greatest 80s hits out there.
Def Leppard.
Like I said, I was 2. I was trying to like rack my brain. I remember the entire like the Breakfast Club soundtrack, and we're trying hard to make sure that plays. And there's also going to be prizes.
Prizes?
I mean, yes. What better way is there to have fun than to give prizes out, right? I think so.
What kind of prize?
There's one large gift basket, which includes gifts from Top of the Hill. We have gift certificates to Back and Around, the record store that's downtown, like actual records, Wade, and cassette tapes.
Mm-hmm. Vinyl?
Wait a minute.
Yes, vinyl records and cassette tapes.
Cassette tapes.
Cassette tapes.
Does anybody still have a cassette tape player to play them on?
She's
got them here. She's got them here in the studio.
I mean, it's possible. I mean, you can find anything on Amazon.
If we get one, we may play it here on the station for you. So they do work.
You will look forward to that in the gift basket. We're stuffing the basket full, so it's going to be worth the effort. And all you have to do is dress up. I mean, who doesn't want to play like your 80s? You can come as Madonna. Whoever was popular in the 80s, you can rock out and be that person for the day.
Oh, wow.
It's going to be fun.
All right. Well, I'm going to switch topics from that for a minute because there's something that you could actually do on Fourth Friday if you want to, but it's going on for a while. I'm not quite sure much longer on, but you were talking about having gone to the Cape Fear Regional Theater and seeing The Crowns.
Yes, it's Crowns.
I went
last night. I think the first show was last night, and I believe it's going through to June 23rd, I want to say. If not, be sure to check out CapeFearRegionalTheater.com so you can see all the dates. But the show was amazing. I went with a friend of mine, and if you were in the church, raised in the church, you know anything about being in the church, trust me, this show is the one you want to see. It brings back memories. It'll have you laughing, crying, and hand clapping. Like, we had church in that theater last night. It was much of a show. Yes, definitely.
I definitely
suggest it. And The Crowns has played nationwide, so it's not like a local play that they're just putting on. It's a great production. Mm-hmm. It's a quality production. And the tickets are reasonably priced. So I say go see it.
I think every time I've been to a program there, it's been very, very well done.
Well, yes.
Very well done.
Yes. And I'm almost ashamed to say that was my first time going there, but it was really great.
We're going to go to a break, and then we'll be right back.
See you guys.
All right. I think you want me to take one with that close of the time left in the show, but I got you. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Okay, we've got a minute on the break.
Okay, so we'll have about 4 minutes left or 3 minutes left.
Four and a half.
Here's Dr. Sabina Francis. So what else do you think we want to cover here?
I'm trying to think. Because I didn't want to misquote that.
Now,
is
there a fee for that Fourth Friday?
The Fourth Friday? No.
It's downtown.
It's free. It's downtown. I should have said that. It's free. You just come downtown.
And
how long have
they been doing
it?
It's every fourth Friday of every month.
Multiple medications.
And there's a different thing every single month. I just happen to be helping to plan this one, so I'm kind of hands-on on it. Every fourth Friday.
Letting us know what's going on in the city. I didn't know nothing about
it. Yeah, come dress, girl. I'm gonna look for you.
Wow.
Look for me, because I'll be floating around down there.
For more information, visit
Boss Man, let me know when you're ready.
Okay.
Fourth Friday.
And we're back on what's going on here at the WIDU Radio Network, WIDU 1600 AM Fayetteville, it's 1160 AM in Red Springs, WAGR 1340 AM Lumberton, WEWO, WEWO 1460 AM Laurinburg. Call-in number is 910-483-6111. We've just been inundated with calls, so, you know, I mean, we really appreciate it. But seriously, if you got a call, give us a call. Talk about anything you want to talk to about what's going on around the area. And, of course, we're on WIDUradio.com. I just came across something that's coming, I guess it's a regular thing, I just look at it, but if you've ever been to the Good Living Coffee Zone over on on Skybow Road, they have the BUGS, which stands for Between Us Girls.
Yes, that's every Tuesday morning.
Yeah, it's an informal gathering of women that meet every Tuesday of each month from 8:30 to 9:30, and some of them meet even earlier at 8 o'clock to socialize prior to the meeting. And it says they help empower women in business through education and networking opportunities. So that's kind of cool. That was something I didn't know that was going on in Fayetteville.
That is cool. And I actually hang out a lot at Good Living Coffee Zone. It's such an amazing spot. Like, the lounge area, you have a couch, you can sit down, you can chill, and the coffee. Can I just tell you about the coffee? If anybody knows, the Mrs. T coffee is just kind of sort of my thing. So their coffee beans are like highest quality possible, and he lets you mix and choose your brew right there. And if you're like me, who just wants to try everything, they can do that for you too, because he will come up with a custom blend just for you.
Yeah, my wife and I go on Tuesdays and Saturdays.
Oh, you have designated days.
Yeah, that's because buy one get one on the gelato.
Yeah,
I'm sorry, I'm cheap.
Hey, nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that. See, I can't designate days because I like too many coffee shops. So
you
I have to.
I was gonna say, you know, because you mentioned you mentioned coffee, which made me think about Hatchet Coffee over at LeClaire's General Store. Which, by the way, LeClaire's General Store in Haymount, next to the Exxon, that has the Colombo yogurt that people up there call Haymount Crack. I mean, it's just really that good.
Well, the name alone lets us.
But it's really that good. I mean, it's like, yeah, I want some more. But anyway, the general store is a meeting place for a lot of people to come and see what's going on, cool, and kind of, you know, connect. And I remember the first time I ever walked into that store, I thought, you know, I'm thinking general store. I'm thinking like a hardware store, that kind of thing. And I'm saying, you know what, you know, I walked in there and said, what in the world is this guy selling besides t-shirts and a few books, you know? And then I found out that everything in the store is for sale.
Everything.
The tables are antiques, the chairs. You can buy the chair you're sitting in.
Part about LeClaire's, Pat, he rearranges. Every time you walk into LeClaire's, it looks like a brand new place. Because he rearranges everything as something sells. He just moves it and shifts it. And it's all based on the fact that Pat used to be a window designer, right?
Yeah.
So that's his passion, and he does it great.
Well, you know, and I think also he operates under the concept that's kind of cool, and I think that's one of the things that we need to learn in the fable is a lot of different small businesses working together, not in competition with each other, but helping each other. So anyway, that's the kind of thing we're trying to develop here through this program is getting people to understand there's a lot of local things going on, local businesses to support, things that can make our community a greater place to live. You know, as I was telling you before we started the show, we've been losing a lot of our youth, our younger people who have grown up here, go to school, graduate, and go somewhere else. Fayetteville's turning into a place where you can stay, you can do stuff for all ages here. Definitely. That's really cool, and that's kind of what we want to focus on with the show. And I want to tell you, thank you so much for coming. Tell everybody how to find your blog and what do they look for so they make sure that Mrs. T's gets... The Mrs. T, I'll get it right, gets seen and read.
Well, thanks, Wade. I really appreciate you inviting me today. And you guys can find me over at themrste.com. It's themrste.com. And I'm at themrst everywhere. So you can tweet me, Instagram me, wherever you want. That's how you'll find me. And I can't wait to share my love of Fayetteville with you guys.
Super. And you can find me at Fowler's Southern Gourmet, 723 West Rowan Street. Thanks for listening in. And thank you, WIDU, for letting us bring this show to you.
Thank you.
That was good. I felt like I got my flow at the end of it.
it takes some practices sometimes.
Yeah.
Thank you for being willing to do this.
Thank you so much for the opportunity. I hope I was a good first run.
Yeah, it was great. What did you think?
Wonderful. You guys were very informative. Stuff I didn't know was going in the midst of my backyard.
Yeah, seriously. There's a lot.
This is Pastor Philip
D. Mark,
Senior,
Presbyterian
Church of Christ, Disciples of Christ. Mm-hmm. And I'd like to welcome
bye, y'all.
Fresh Words.
Bye, guys. I forgot to say bye. Be sure to tune in to Wade every Saturday at 9 a.m. on WIDU 1600 a.m. And maybe he'll invite me back and you guys can see me again. See you later.
That 13th verse.